Everything belongs to God, and all things were created by His power. So God did the right thing when He made Jesus perfect by suffering. As Jesus led many of God's children to be saved and to share in His glory, Jesus and the people He makes holy all belong to the same family. This is why He isn't ashamed to call them His brothers and sisters. He even said to God, "I will tell them your name and sing your praises when they come together to worship." He also said, "I will trust God." Then He said, "Here I am with the children God has given me." We are people of flesh and blood. This is why Jesus became one of us. He died to destroy the devil who had power over death. But He also died to rescue all of us who live each day in fear of dying. Jesus clearly did not come to help angels, but He did come to help Abraham's descendants. He had to be one of us so He could serve God as our merciful and faithful high priest and sacrifice Himself for the forgiveness of our sins. And now that Jesus has suffered and was tempted, He can help anyone else who is tempted. Those words come from Hebrews chapter 2, verses 10 to 18. When you are tempted, there is something inside of you that is calling your name and urging you to disobey God. You will hear rational arguments and be urged to fulfill the lusts of the flesh and indulge yourself in the pride of life. Satan's tactics today are the same as they were in the Garden of Eden with the temptation of the first man and woman. Then came Jesus, who suffered and Himself was tempted to sin, but Jesus never, not even once, gave in to temptation and certainly is the world's greatest authority on how to defeat every temptation in your life. So when the temptation to sin is knocking at the door of your heart and mind, it is time to call out to Jesus for help. Jesus will not ignore your request for help in overcoming temptation and will surely show you the way through it to victory over sin. Lord Jesus, when temptation comes my way today, remind me to call out to You for the help You promised so that I may, by Your power, defeat every temptation to sin. May You be praised forever. Amen.